Today we are going to learn about window handling in Selenium WebDriver. Guys, it is one of very important and frequently used concept when you are working with the real-time projects. So let's try to understand few key concepts that are related with the window handling. As the part of this session, we will learn like what is the main or parent window, why there is need to handle the different window, what is the window handle in the Selenium, and in the last we will see window handling methods. So let's start. So I have created this document and I would like to walk you through with this document, and in parallel we will see these things practically. So let me create one program here. So let's create one class as window handle and let's name as one window handle one. Select the main method from here and let's utilize the code to launch the Chrome browser. So I will use the URL Gmail sign up. So let's put it here. When you click on it, you will be directed to create a Google account. Okay, so let's see what is our first point. So the first point is parent or main window in Selenium. So a window on which user is directed after hitting the URL is known as a parent or main window. And by default, the WebDriver is focused on that window only. Let's execute this program. So here you can see that the window on which user is directed after hitting the URL. So this window becomes our parent window. And WebDriver is focused on this window by default as well. Right? And let's move to the next point. What is the need to handle the different window? WebDriver will always have the context of the main window. So the context means on which window it will be working by default, and it is possible to open the different window inside the main window. Those windows will be known as the child window, and for each child window there will be the separate context. And the next thing is Selenium works in a specific context. So to automate such cases where we want to work on the child window, we need to switch our context from main window to the child window only. Okay, so if we talk about this page, so here we can see like this is our main page or parent page, and let's click on this help link. So what happens now? A new page is opened, okay, and its title is Google account info. This page becomes the child window of our parent page, okay. And in case we want to work on this Google account help page, then we need to switch our context from create your Google account to Google account home page. Okay. Let's move to the next point. So the next point is window handle in the Selenium. So actually it stores the unique address of the browser window. So it is sort of pointed to a window. Its return type is alphanumeric and it's unique for each window. As each opened window will have ID, using which we will able to switch the WebDriver context to that window and perform the required operations on the same. So here, what does it mean? It means that for each window, like for this one or this one, let's open few more like privacy and terms. So for each window, there will be a window handle. So basically, what does the window handle do? So window handle, it is a unique value for each window, and it's in the alphanumeric format, right? So say like we want to switch on the multiple window, in that case we need to use that ID, and with the help of that ID we can switch from one window to other window. Okay, So let's move to the window handling methods. First one is like get window handle. So it is used to get the ID of current window, which gets open when a session is created and its return type is string. Okay. We have already launched this URL and created one session. So let's try to capture the window handle for this one. So what the method we need to use? We need to use the get window handle. We'll write here the driver dot get window handle and its return type is a string. So let's store it in a string variable. Main window handle, right? And let's simply print it out. Main window handle. And now when we will execute this program, so it will return the window handle for the current window, that is this one, and its value should be alphanumeric. So let me close this and let's execute this program and see what happens here. So here you can see like it has launched the create your Google account. It has printed a unique value for this window and it's in alphanumeric format. Okay, so let's move to the next method. So the next method is get window handles. So it is used to get the total number of the window opened by the web driver, and the return type of this method is set of strings. Okay, so as of now you can see like it has opened only one window. So first we need to open a child window here. So how we can open the child window? So you can click on any of these links. So let's try to open one child window here. Click on help link. Okay. So first, so let's capture the this help link web element. So it has the text as help, so we can utilize the same. So I will write the driver dot find element y dot link text, and our link text is help, and simply click so that a new window gets opened here. Okay, so let's see, is it opening or not. Here you can see like it has opened the Google account help page as well. So now we have the two windows with us. Let's try to get the total number of windows that are opened by this driver. So I will write the driver dot get. You can see like there is a method that is the get window handles and it is returning set of a string. So let's utilize the same and capture the values in one variable. I can create like win handles. So this method has returned all the IDs in set data structure, like the parent window, child window, and now we need to use the iterator to pull those IDs. I will write the win handles dot iterator. Import the correct package for iterator. So I will import this java.util. Okay. And now with the help of next method, we will get the parent window handle ID and the child window handle ID. So we can write in this way like id dot next, and we can store it inside the string variable parent win. Okay, let's print out parent window handle ID. So I will write this out and parent window handle ID Okay, so now to get the child window handle ID, we again need to write the ID dot next, and let's store it inside a string variable. So I will write the string child win. Okay, simply print it out. Child window handle. Okay. Let's execute this program and see what happens. Simply right click and run a Java application. So here you can see like it has opened the create your Google account, as well as after clicking on help link, it has opened the Google account help page. And here is the output for the same. And if you have noticed, then you can see like these two IDs are same. The reason is that in the statement number 17, we are just using the get window handle and trying to retrieve the window handle ID for the URL which we have mentioned in the line number 16. Okay. And after that, we have clicked on the home button so that a child window gets opened as well. And now we are trying to get the total number of windows that are opened by the browser. And after that, we are using the iterator to iterate those windows one by one. And here I am using the it.next. So it has picked the ID of the parent window. That's why these two window IDs are the same. Okay. And if you continue on the next, so you will get the IDs for the other open windows as well. And the next method is switch2, and it is used to perform the switch operation within Windows. So I will create a separate video to explain the switch2 context, and then we will see that how we can perform the switch operation between multiple windows. Okay guys, so that's it for today's video. I hope you liked it. Thank you for watching. Thank you so much.